Hello everybody, this is Dr. Madigan. We're here to challenge some conventional wisdom once again. Today we're talking about cholesterol, and I do want to say first off that if you're going to make any decisions about going off of medication or getting on a medication, that's something you have to have between you and your physician. I just want to educate you on what's going on. And I also want to let you know that eating cholesterol in your diet is something that is perfectly safe, okay? So conventional wisdom on cholesterol, this is a big one. Everybody knows about this word. Cholesterol. It's talked about all the time. If you watch a football game, there's probably about 15 commercials for Crestor or all those different statin medications. Okay, conventional wisdom says strictly limit your intake of dietary cholesterol. Increased cholesterol levels lead to increased risk of heart disease. Eliminate eggs if cholesterol is high or there's a family history. Take statin drugs if over 200, if your cholesterol is over 200, or if there's a family history. Unfortunately, now, if your cholesterol is over 200 and your doctor doesn't prescribe a statin drug to you, it can be seen as malpractice and they can be sued. So, really sad state of affairs as far as I'm concerned. So when we look at the reality of cholesterol from the 6 for 60 perspective, there's little or no evidence of heart disease risk. Okay, and that's not again from the Department of Dr. Matt's Fly By Your Seat of Your Pants stat book. That's actually from the Framingham Heart Study and the Nurse Heart Study, which are two of the largest studies on heart disease ever really conducted. Okay, and they're finding little correlation, very little correlation between heart disease and cholesterol levels. Cholesterol is an essential metabolic nutrient, so much so that 80% of the cholesterol in your bloodstream is actually produced by your body itself. Okay, that's really important to remember. 80% of the cholesterol that you have in your body actually comes from your body. Your liver makes it because it's so essential. Every cell in your body, the membrane of that cell, needs cholesterol to function properly. Statin drugs have many side effects. If you have ever watched any of those commercials that I'm talking about, you'll see that half of them are talking about the side effects, which include death and stiff joints and all these kind of things that we would really like to avoid in our daily lives. Cholesterol is only really dangerous if it coexists with a poor diet and exercise plan. So if your cholesterol is 450 and you haven't been off the couch in 10 years, yeah, maybe it's a good idea to take some of these interventions. But it really is only dangerous, in my opinion, with a poor diet and exercise regimen. Diet minimally affects overall cholesterol. As we said before, 80% of cholesterol that's in your bloodstream actually comes from your body itself. Your diet minimally affects it. So we went back to eggs here. That's one thing that people say to strictly avoid eggs. And in the last video I talked about how Becky and I have very good cholesterol numbers. We eat, between the two of us and our 16-month-old Cole, we eat over 2 dozen eggs a week. And my cholesterol is very, 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 very good, very, very low, very, very healthy for a man of my age. And Becky's is, I think, like 11 or 12 points below the average, just like a cardiologist's dream come true. Her cholesterol is perfect, and we eat all these eggs. So it's not eating the cholesterol that gives you high cholesterol. Actually, it's directly the amount of cholesterol in your bloodstream. If you look at the physiology and biochemistry of cholesterol, it's directly related to the amount of stress that's happening on a metabolic level in your cells. So really, ultimately, if you want to lower the cholesterol number in your bloodstream, you want to lower the amount of stress that's happening in your cells. One good way of doing that is by not eating a lot of sugar. Another good way of doing that is by following some of the other principles that we talk about in the 6 for 60 program. All right, that was a lot of information, really quick, but I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you in the next video.